Alrighty. Hi, art friends. Welcome. I'm glad that you are here today. So sorry that we could not be together this week, but we're all just trying to stay safe, healthy, and clean during this time. So I hope you guys are having a good break off of school. But I really miss you guys, and I hope we are back here soon together. But if not, I'm gonna keep doing these videos for you guys. Alright, so today I thought we would make a tulip for the first day of spring. That was yesterday, I hear. So I thought today we could make some nice tulips, since it's the first day of spring. Now, I have this mixed media sketchbook paper by Canson. If you don't have this, guys, it's okay. Just use what you have. If you have a canvas, that'd be great. But I'm not gonna work on a canvas today, just so I could show you, if you don't have a canvas, that it's fine to work on paper. I might get a little fancy with this paper in a minute, but I will show you step by step how to paint it. So, and I like looking at visual references, so I'm also gonna pull up a picture of a tulip for myself. There's one picture I found that I thought you guys could do, and that we all could do. But I also might just change it a little bit. So that's the one I chose. Nice red tulips. And I'm gonna show you how to draw them, and then we're gonna paint them. So it's not gonna look like this. It's gonna look like however we make it, but we're gonna try our best, okay? So this video is about an hour long. I'm gonna try to keep it an hour, but if you got other stuff to do, you could pause, you could stop it, whatever you so choose. And then if we run out of time, we'll finish it next time. And then if we have more time, then I'll show you some other things that you could do in your time that you are at home, just to give you some ideas. So there you go. I'm gonna keep this by me, and it's got some music playing, so I hope you guys don't mind. All right, so I feel like we should get a little fancy with this. So I'm gonna draw an oval. Just to make it a little different. You guys don't have to do this, but I'm just doing it because I think it's different, and I think it looks nice if it's a different shape. Now, you can buy a... Oh, I hope you can see that. Yeah, that's my oval. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. There we go. Yeah, I hope you guys can see that. So that's my oval. You can buy canvases that are in the shape of an oval, too, at the craft store. Not so much at Walmart, but they might have them at Walmart. But probably go to your craft store if you want something like oval shape. They do sell canvases in an oval shape. I don't know about like triangle shape or anything like that, but they do sell oval shape. So if you didn't know that before, now you know. So I'm just gonna cut that out. Try your best to cut it in the shape. Like I said, you don't have to do this oval shape. I'm just doing it to be fancy. And you know what? It's a little different because we've never done this before. There you go. Okay. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna go straight to the background. Now the background can be whatever color you want. I'm gonna stick with some blue, maybe some white. Now if you don't have a palette like this, you could use a paper plate. The reason why I don't use paper plate for the most part is because it absorbs the paint faster and you just keep wasting paint that way. I like to do it in a palette or Even on a recycled lid like this, lids are the best thing, I feel like, to mix paint, because if they get too icky sticky, then you could just throw them away, or recycle. Recycle is important. So if you don't have a nice fancy palette like that, you can always just use a lid to a jar and mix from there. So I'm just gonna add a little blue. Now I'm gonna be working with acrylic paint. Oop, there we go, acrylic paint. If you do not have acrylic paint at home, that's okay. You can work with tempera. Tempera is fine. Tempera is washable. Now if you're working with acrylic, it might get on your clothes and it might not wash out. So that's why I do stress that. So I'm gonna add, I'm just gonna put my white in here because I don't think we're gonna need that much. So there we go. Now I'm gonna get my brush. I like working, when I'm doing my backgrounds, I like working with like a big bristle brush. Oh, or like a square brush. I do like square brushes a lot. They're just like a lot smoother and I feel like they do cover a nice surface. They also have like these thinner square brushes. But again, if you don't have that, that's fine. Just use what you have. If you don't have a brush, you can use your finger. I don't care. Your parents might care, so just be wary of that. So I'm gonna... And I'm not scribbling, I'm just covering. But before I continue, I'm actually gonna cover the table. Because I didn't think about that. I should cover the table where I'm working. So that way it doesn't get messy. There you go, fits perfectly and you won't get, it's easy cleanup. You just recycle your paper. And the reason why I'm just going straight to the background is that we're gonna put our tulips onto the background. And I'm gonna show you how we're gonna do that. Now I'm just gonna add a little white in there. And see how it's making that like nice streakiness? So I'm just doing wet paint to wet paint. And it's adding those streaks and I'm really blending it in. How you blend it in is you keep brushing it back and forth in. Oop, got a little. Oh, make sure you also have a cup of water. I like using yogurt containers because, you know, they're easy for kiddos to dip their brush in and the water doesn't spray everywhere. And you know what? We're recycling, so please try to use your yogurt containers. For kiddos, ask your family members, like, hey, can I have your yogurt containers? They'll be like, yeah, sure. There we go. So I'm just going into the blue. And this is just a regular bright blue. If you want to get a little bit darker, you can go darker, but I'm just going to stick with my bright blue. It's a very nice blue. And if you don't like that white in there, you could always cover it up with the blue. You could always cover it up. But try, when you're painting, it's best if you try to stay in the same direction. And you're gonna get a little paint on your fingers because you have to hold your paper down. If you want to tape your paper down, you can also do that. But try to paint in the same direction. Makes it look a little bit nicer. This would also be a nice painting to do in watercolor, I feel like. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of white again. And see, I'm just brushing that white in there. Get a little bit more. And I'm just making those streaks. I'm just going back and forth. Watch my hand. And this just takes practice. Getting those like nice streakies. 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 Streaks of white. Kind of gives it like a feathery sky look, I feel like. And it also gets that like nice light blue in there. which is also pretty nice. There we go. Alrighty, and then I'm gonna clean my brush. And then make sure you have paper towels, because I do not have paper towels, so I have to jump out and get paper towels. Hold on, I'll be right back. Alright, so you're gonna want to let this dry for a little bit. So I know kiddos don't like to be patient and let things dry, but you know what? We have to be patient sometimes. So I'm gonna grab my hair dryer as well, just for the purpose of this video. So that way you're not waiting a whole ton. So it's gonna get a little loud, just saying. Okay. So, just be careful when you're blow drying. There we go. Wow. Ooh, that's already, like, dry. It's a little tacky, but... go. See, that's already dry. And if you're working on paper, so it kind of looks like an Easter egg, right? It looks like an Easter egg. So if you're working on canvas, it's going to take a little longer to dry because canvas is not as absorbent as paper, but paper will dry a little faster. So I just use the blow dryer to give it a little kickstart. So now what we're going to be doing is we're going to be drawing. Now, I hope you're going to be able to see this part. Woohoo. Okay. Sorry for all the moving around. I apologize. All right. So we're going to start drawing. Now, like I said, you can go off a ref, like this is called a reference photo. So a photo that you look at in order to draw something else, or draw something similar to it. Doesn't have to look exactly like it. So I'm gonna start at the bottom, and I'm just gonna go straight up. That is gonna be my first tulip. There we go. And you could cover those pencil lines with the paint. So, that's my first one. And then if you want to get over, we can overlap. So I'm just going to put a leaf right here. Hope you could see that. So there we go. I have a stem and I have a leaf. Zoom out a little bit more. And then you could add some little leaves here and there in the back, whichever you so choose. And then I'm gonna make my stem for my second tulip. And that one's gonna be a little bit shorter and it's gonna be off to the side. And then I'm gonna do like another big leaf right here. So there's my second tulip. That is the stem. And that is the leaf. And then we can do one more. One more. So I'm going to go on this side. And I did my third leaf. And you could have little leaves here and there. Now, if you don't know how to draw a leaf, I'm going to go over that right now. So, this just looks like a bunch of curves and some lines, but I promise you it's going to turn into something. So, to draw a leaf, or I'm going to show you what I did in Sharpie. So, I just drew my stem. This is just my scrap sheet of paper. So, I just did two lines, and they're kind of curved, so give it a little bit of a curve. They're not straight up and down. They got a little bit of a curve to it. And then to draw my leaf, I like to start at the bottom, work my way up, give it a nice bigger curve, kind of like a half smile. And then I'm gonna swoop in. So I'm gonna start swooping in first, and then I'm gonna make a big bump and go back out until I go back down and make a little point. And most leaves have like a center line, so if you want to add that center line, you can. We might do that later while we're working. So we could add that center line later. So I'm going to start with the petals now. The petals, the red petals. But they're not red yet, so. So what we're going to do is I'm just gonna make a light circle. So light that you could barely see it, because I'm just making the shape of the tulip right now. It's kind of like a circle with the top part chopped off. So I'm just gonna show you like this. I'm gonna do three circles because we're making three tulips. Just like that. Here, I'll bring it closer to you so that way you can see. So, I just did circles right now. Those are just circles. I'm gonna show you what I mean. So here, I'm doing it on the other paper. So now we're gonna draw the petals. Now the petals are similar to like drawing leaves. They're just like a little bit thicker with a little less swoop in them. So I'm gonna start at the top. Actually, I'm gonna start at the bottom, work my way up, and give it like a little point, and then go back down. So it's kind of looking like a leaf right now. Oh, there we go. But I'm just doing it on this half of my circle. Just do it on that half of the circle for right now. And then there's gonna be like a middle petal. So I'm gonna start at the bottom, right there of my leaf. And I'm gonna go up. And you can just make it a little point if you want. That's up to you. Kind of like that. It's kind of like a half leaf almost, or a very pointed oval. Oops, sorry. So it's like a half leaf right now. A little bit of a fat leaf. Or a very pointy oval. And then what you could do is we're gonna go on to the third petal, which is, I'm just gonna go out, give it a little swoop in, and back down. Okay? And that's pretty much a tulip, guys. So that is pretty much a tulip. And then you could put a little bit extra in there with some few extra petals here and there. So give it some more petals to give it a little bit more body, a little bit more width to the flower, if you will. And we're gonna do the same to the other two. Now in my picture, you can't really see the other two. They're kind of cut off. Now that one's a little different, so I might do something. Oop. So I'm gonna do a little bit like that one. That one on the left, or right. So I'm gonna start on the left side this time. I'm gonna start on the left side. Go out. I'm doing the opposite this time. I'm making that fat belly first, going up. Out and then back down. And we're all gonna paint over this, so don't worry if you're overlapping lines. You don't have to erase. If you wanna erase, you can. That's fine too. Just make sure your paper is completely dry before you start erasing. All right, I'm gonna go on the right side now. And I'm just gonna make it flare out. So see how that one curves in, then curves in again, and then makes a little fat belly? So this one, I just went up and down. Kind of like, almost like an upside down V. So I kind of just went up, and then I just curved it down to the shape of my circle. Now I'm gonna make that like center part that they have. So I'm gonna use my circle that I drew, and I'm gonna just do two bumps, just like that. So it kind of looks like a little fishy mouth, or like a fish. Kind of looks like a fishy mouth. And then for that one, I'm just gonna add the extra petals behind it, and I'm just doing like upside down V. I'm just going up and down, up then down. And I'm gonna do one more. Just like that. Okay. Now the third one, if you're feeling ready, you could tackle that one on your own. But if you want to follow me, I'm just gonna do this one a little differently if you want just a little variety to the different petals that you can make. So this one, I'm gonna go starting at the bottom of my stem. So right at the bottom of my stem, and then I'm gonna go up past that circle point. So I'm past the circle now. And then I'm going down. So it kind of looks like a little rabbit ear. Or a leaf, it looks like a leaf. So here's what I'm doing for the petals. I'm gonna show you, just if I didn't explain it, or like you didn't see it, because the pencil is a little bit light. So I'm gonna show you in this circle right here. So for my petals, I'm pretty much using the curve of my circle, and then I'm just going out, back in, kind of making a little triangle. And there we go. And kind of giving it just like a little side swoop. Or if you want to make like a belly, I call it. So you go make your belly, then we go out, and then up, and then curve like that. Make a little point. Add the little ones in the background. That's not the best example. So I'm gonna try it again. So I'm gonna do the third petal that I'm doing. So here's kind of like my leaf shape. And then you could go out like this. Go out like this. That's another way you could do a tulip, super simple. And then you kind of just do little, almost like triangles. Just like that. And then here's your stem. So that's a very simple way of doing a tulip, but we're doing it a little bit differently, or at least I'm showing you a little bit differently on how to do it on my piece of paper. I'm just kind of going off the example that I see here, but it's a little harder to draw from a picture. You really have to look at it, really study it, practice. Definitely practice your lines. If you don't want to go straight on to your canvas or your painted page, just do it on a practice sheet. Really practice first before you jump ahead to just going onto the surface that you made, because you only get one canvas sometimes, and that canvas has to last you through the whole entire painting. Or you would just end up with like a random canvas with a background, that's it. There wouldn't be anything on it. So please use your canvas. But if please practice first and then use your canvas. That's what I'm trying to stress. Alrighty. So I'm gonna go out and up and down. I'm gonna do it again. So out, curve, up, down. Then add the little ones in the background. Okay. Now I feel like we're ready to go on to the next part, which is painting it. So I'm gonna zoom out a little bit more. So I have my white paint. I have my blue paint. I'm also gonna have yellow and red, because yellow and red are also our primary colors. Now primary colors, you cannot make these. So primary colors you cannot make. So if anything, if you were to buy paint, just stick with these three, especially if you're on a budget. Don't buy the whole rainbow. It will get expensive. So if you had red, yellow, blue, kiddos, you're gonna have to learn how to mix. You're gonna have to practice making colors and mixing colors. It's hard to match colors, so if you are worried about running out of a color, make a lot of it. We may have to make a lot of a certain color. So, but then I also like buying green, because like green, there are so many different shades of green. And then definitely buy black and white. Black and white are your highlights and shadows, your value, your neutral colors. So please buy black and white, so that way you can make things lighter or darker if you need to. Okay, I'm gonna go with a different brush now. I'm gonna go with like a nice soft tip round brush. If you don't have one, that's okay. Usually if you buy like a watercolor set, they usually come with these brushes, which are really nice. But again, if you don't have that, just try to find the best brush you have. These brushes are not gonna be your best friend. These are hard. Not the best brush. No. I use these for glue mostly. If it's the only thing you have, you can try it with this brush. I just prefer these ones. So I'm just gonna stick with these ones. But again, use what you have. If you're finger painting or using a Q-tip, go ahead and use that too. Maybe turn this into a finger painting project. You never know. So I'm gonna pour a good amount of red because we're gonna need it. All right. Now, if we wanna go full red tulips, go for it. But if you wanna make like a nice soft pink, you can. I feel like I'm just gonna stick with red for this project. So if you wanna outline first, I suggest that. That's just my opinion. So I'm just gonna put some black in another one of my trays. I'm gonna scoop some red into another empty one, because I'm gonna mix a dark red. So that dark red is gonna be kind of like our shadows, and then we'll mix like a lighter red using our white. So get your paper towel ready, and then just add like, just dip your brush in the black just a little bit. You don't need much. And there we go. We get like a nice maroon color. So that's gonna be our outline slash shadow. So there we go. I like that. Okay, I'm actually gonna switch to a different brush. I'm gonna use a thinner brush, especially for just like outlining. So make it wet. And then I'm gonna dip it in my dark red. And then I'm gonna start on this far one. So when we add the actual red, it might look different. You might have to be careful. And we might be covering up some of these lines, but I'm just doing this to show you. Sometimes people color it red and then they add their shadows, but I feel like then we would lose our lines, and I don't want you guys to lose your lines because you guys are still learning. So I'm just gonna trace them. And I'm going fast, but I want you guys to take your time. Take your time, and if you don't like the way I'm doing it, and you want to try something on your own, you can. So I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. So that is my first tulip right there. Just super simple outline, nothing fancy. And so I'm on my second one right now. And sorry if I'm speaking loudly, I just want to make sure you're able to hear me. But I am right next to the camera too, so that doesn't help. I hope you guys are having fun and having a good break. Doing a lot of fun stuff. If you're crafting, I love it. Yes, paint, practice, craft. Always be making things. That's very important. Very good thing to do. Keeps you busy. All right, this one's gonna look a little different because we drew it a little different. Oh. And I'm just using the tip of my brush. Try not to use your full brush, because then you're going to get those bigger lines, where we just want a thin, nice thin line. Add some more water if you need to. And I'm just going very lightly, very lightly. So if you want like a very skinny line, you're going to barely touch that paper with your brush. So I'm just barely touching the paper. You're not going to make like a whole perfect crisp line all at once. But you're kind of like connecting the dots almost. You're just doing little strokes. Like you're, you know, petting the paper with your brush. Like you're petting a mouse with your paintbrush. You know, you gotta be gentle. I almost went into my red. Alrighty. So I just did the outline of my petals. If you want to go back to a bigger brush, you can. I feel like bigger brushes are more for the surface area, but if you are feeling confident, go to the bigger brush. If not, stick with the small one. Nothing wrong with the small one. Small one is actually better, I feel like, because you get those little spaces that you can't get with the big one, unless you know how to work a big one and can just lightly get into those smaller spaces, then great. So there we go. So I'm gonna use the big brush, and then I'm gonna probably switch over back to the small one. So I'm gonna fill in and you may need to cover those darker lines. Or you could get blendy with it. If it's still wet, maybe even try to cover those lines. Because that dark red will show through that light red, especially if you're just putting this little amount on it. So there we go. I'm gonna go to the side petal. Maybe go over that red line. Want that value, that shadow. Get into the little ones. So I'm going over those red lines, maroon lines that we drew, did our outline with, just to give it that shadow that we want. And it's okay if you don't want to do that. If you just want to color inside the lines, that's fine too. That's what we are also trying to teach you guys, is stay inside the lines. But if you want to go over the lines to make that shadow in this project, you can. So don't feel like you're stuck just doing inside the lines. You can go over those lines. I feel like that's giving us our shadows right now, instead of going back and doing that over again. So I'm gonna just lift it up so you could see. So I just went over our red lines, so it gives us that blending effect. So they're not so harsh like this. And I should have held it up when I just filled it in. So I'm gonna fill it in again, just inside the lines, and then I'm gonna go over those dark red lines and show you what I mean. So careful, I am left-handed, so it got on me. Just be careful where you're placing your hand. I should have mentioned this earlier, but be careful when you're painting left to right, because that's how we're taught to write. Now, if you're doing that, if you're painting left to right, just be careful on where your hand is, because if you're resting it on the paper, that's fine, but make sure it's a nice dry spot. If you're resting it right in the wet paint and you don't realize it, then it's gonna get all over your palm. So I'm just filling in those lines. I'm not going over the maroon lines yet, that dark red that we did. Okay, now I'm gonna show you what I mean. So look at this one compared to this one. You still see those sharp lines. Now we're gonna go over them. This will give us that dark red color that we want as our shadows, kind of. Again, if you don't want to do that and you're feeling comfortable just doing coloring inside, that's fine. Do what you feel comfortable doing. There you go. Just like that. Now some people just don't go into color. They do this white first. And the reason why they do that is so that way you don't get the color of the background popping out at you. You can do that. I chose not to. I kind of feel like that red is strong enough not to pick up that blue background as much. But I mean, it is a darker red because that blue is our background. But people like to do white, so that way they don't have to compete with that background. But for you guys, I just did straight into red. So you don't have to do that. If you watch other tutorials online, kiddos, they'll show you something different. I'm just showing you this way because this is how I know, how I'm used to. I'm not a skilled painter, but I try my best. Like I'm more of a potter. I am a ceramic person. I like to work with clay. Some of you like to work in crayon and colored pencil, and that is totally fine. We all have our different mediums. So when I say mediums, it means that we like to work in a specific specific area of art. So some people are painters. That is their medium. That is what I say when I say medium. That is their medium. Meaning that is what they choose to work in, is paint. Some people like to work in ink. That is another thing. They like to work in ink. Some people like to do photography. That's another medium. But my medium is clay. I like 3D things. Some people don't like 3D things. Some people don't understand how to make a 3D thing. But 2D is hard for me. So just go with what you're comfortable with, what you like to do. Don't let anybody tell you no when choosing your medium. But listen to your parents. All right, so I am done with my red. So there we go. Now I'm gonna go straight into green. Because we want our red to dry, and then we could add some highlights here and there. So highlights meaning where the light is coming from. So like pretend that like there's a sun up here. So we're gonna put like a little bit of highlight on our little petals right there. Actually we might do that right now. We're gonna do that now. So we're not gonna go to green. We're gonna go straight to our red highlights. So I'm gonna scoop up some red, put it in here, maybe some more because I don't want you guys to run out. But that's pretty much all you need. And then scoop it into the white. Be careful, you will contaminate the white. Oops. Sorry guys. This thing is taped so that way it doesn't fall. Oop, but it's falling. Oh, technical difficulties. Sorry. Ugh, so sorry, I apologize. Here we go. So my tape just came off. Ooh, ooh. Okay, I think it's good. There we go. Alrighty. So, I'm gonna mix and see how I got that nice light pink. Oh. So that's kind of like a nice, almost like a fuchsia pink, but fuchsia's a little bit darker, and I think fuchsia has a little bit of purple in there. So if you want to add pink, that's a little too pink. I feel like we should go a little bit more red, so I'm gonna scoop in a little bit more red. Sorry, I'm going a little too red. I think I added too much white. So we got a lot of pink. So I actually like that pink a little better. The one that's mixing in the red. Because I just want a little off red, not necessarily pink, but like a light. If you want, you could just add some streaks here and there to add a little highlight. So I did like a little streak up there. And then we're gonna mostly, so since the light is gonna be at the top, I'm just gonna put those little highlights up there. Again, if you don't like that, you don't have to do this. I'm just doing it to show you that it's possible to do highlights, but this might not be the best way of showing you. Here we go. You could add it also on the sides or in the middle. So we're adding some light color to our tulips. Oop, I just went straight into that pink. So I'm just adding a touch of pink here and there, or I shouldn't say pink, it's like an off-red. Alright, so I just did a little bit. So that's all you need, you just need a little bit, not a lot. And I'm just following the lines that I did with that maroon color. Alright, now let's move on to the green, because we are running out of time, so I hope we could finish this in the time that we have. I'm trying to just stay within an hour. Try to resemble as much as the class as possible. I know it's not exactly the same, but... Alright, you just need a little bit. Now, in my picture, I'm seeing, like, a light green, a medium green, and a dark green. I think I just might do a light and a dark green, just so I could show you. Actually, maybe I'll do the three different types of green. So I'm gonna dip into my black, or actually dip into my green, because we're gonna be mixing. So that's gonna be my medium green, kind of like our reds. We had that dark red, we have our red, and then we had our light red, which was like a light pink, but then I went back to that red because like that I wanted a little bit of darker color. So here's, and then I'm gonna scoop some into third one. So this one's gonna be actually our medium green. So that one we're gonna make our dark green. So I'm gonna add a little bit of black. Just a slight dot, that's all you need. Now it's turning into like a gray green, which I'm not caring for, so I'm gonna add a little tip of blue. Cause blue will get it back to like a hunter green. That's kinda what I want. I would like a actual like, you know, like this color green, but I have like this lighter green, so I'm just gonna do with the best with what I have. And so see that difference? It's kind of like a gray green, but I added that blue to give it like a more of a dark green color, more than a gray green. If you want to add more black, you can. I'm just adding a little dip of black, but it's turning out more gray than I like. But if you like that green, go for it. And so I'm gonna just do the leaves right now. And what you could do is you could draw a line through that leaf with your pencil. And then half of that leaf is gonna be that dark green that you see. So I just separated my leaf into two parts. And there you go. And you can do that for all of them if you like. You don't have to. I'm actually gonna do that little leaf that I did back here, that dark green, because that's in the back. And when things are in the back, they tend to be darker. And try your best to get those points back to your leaf. It's hard with a round brush, but you just gotta be like super light when you touch the paper. See? Just gotta gently touch that paper to get that point. Okay? Now, if you want to separate another leaf in half, go for it. This is your project. I might do that for a couple of them. So I'm separating this leaf in half. I drew a line straight down the middle. And then I'm going to do the left side of that dark green. And then I'm going to do this one. I'm going to split this one in half. Do the right side, that dark green. And I'm rushing a little bit, but take your time. Here you go. All right. Now, if you want to do a whole leaf that dark green, go ahead. I'm not gonna, just because that's what I don't want. Actually, I will. I'm gonna do it. So that one's gonna be this dark green. All right. Okay. So now I'm gonna clean my brush. Clean it really good. Make sure there's none of that green in there. And then I'm gonna go to my medium green, so the middle one. Cause then that other green is gonna be like our highlight green. So I'm just going. And that might be a little bright for you guys, but I like it. And then when you reach that flower, what you could do is make like little feathery lines to make it look like that's where the flower and the stem meet. They have like those little lines. It's probably got a name for it, like a scientific name for that, but I don't know it. This is a very light green. So this is a leaf. Or like a blade of grass. It could be a blade of grass if you want it to be. There we go. Feathery part. There we go. Yeah, I should have maybe done like a darker green for this one because it's very light to dark right now. Very light to dark. So I apologize for that. This green should have been my highlight green. So you could always fix that if you want, but if you like it this way, go. Good for you. That's fine too. It doesn't have to look a certain way. I'm just trying to go off the picture that I'm looking at. But if you like it this way, it's okay too. All All right, I got about 5 more minutes left. Just enough time for the highlights, probably. Okay, now for the highlights, go into that white. Try not to get any red in there. You're gonna get like a little minty green. There you go. That's a really light green, but I like that. So if you wanna go in and add those highlights, you can. If you want to do half of a leaf, that light mint green, you can do that. I'm just kind of doing my own thing right now. Like I said, you don't have to follow the pictures. You could just do your own thing. See what works for you, see what doesn't. Want to get up here into those little feathery parts, you can. You can also like blend that light green in by just like mixing it with that other green, like go back and forth between that light green and that dark green, or that medium green, I should say. And you could kind of blend it too. So that's another way of thinking about this. You could also blend. Makes it look a little nicer. So if you don't like that harsh light color, go back to that medium color and you could cover that up. But a little bit of that light color will peek through. And you're spreading it because you're still, that paint is still wet. So you're kind of making that little blend of color right there. It's up to you. Whatever you feel like doing. All right. Okay. And that is tulips, guys. More simple version. I really like it. I hope you guys too. I hope you like this video. So I just wanted to say a few more things. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any other, need other ideas, here's another idea for a painting project. Just go outside. Find any rock. I want you to find just any rock, and I want you to picture what you see in that rock. And so this, I did this years ago. It has seen time and weather because it's been outside. Now for this, I just found this rock, probably by a river, but please don't go by a river by yourself. Maybe go on a walk with your mom, parent, or whoever's watching you. Find a rock that you like. And see what you see in it. See what it could be. So this one, I saw a watermelon. So this is supposed to be a watermelon. So I just did a line of green, made like the stripes that are on a watermelon with a darker green, did it red, and then added like little black dots for the seeds. And there you go, you have a watermelon. There are so many other ideas out there for painting rocks, so you might want to ask your mom or dad if they could look online for you for some rock painting ideas. But that's another idea. Also, if you have any old CDs around, some of you have already done this project. This is a super fun one for even